So I wanted to run down briefly on the program that I use to edit my Sims photos and how to get something that looks like this. So just a quick intro tutorial, something easy that, you know, you can just get something very simplistic like this, but it still looks really good. So I'll jump straight into it. You want to go to File and then go to Open. And you want to go to your Documents, your Electronic Arts folder, Sims 4 or Sims 3, whatever game that you play, and you just come down to your screenshots. So over in the corner here, the right corner, it does show you a preview. So you can scroll through all your different photos and select. And you basically just go open and it will open up the file. So here's an example of one that I haven't done, and I'll show you two ways on how to get a transparent background, b, how to change the background to, say, a different color, a solid color, and c, how to get a border around your sim. So something looking like this. The first way that I do this, so this is how I personally have used this program, is this tool here that says the Paths tool, Create and Edit Paths. So you select that. Now to move in, to zoom in, it is the plus, and to zoom out, it is the minus. So if you've got tricky areas, you can obviously zoom right in and get right around. So I will begin. It doesn't overly matter too much, I found, if you're not exact along the line. The border does help when you add that in to sort of hide any mishaps and whatnot. But you play around with it and you get pretty used to it. It's pretty good. So we'll go through this now. To make a quick point too, make sure that you don't re-hit the first dot that you put down. So just kind of put it next to it. If I'm wrong, let me know, but I seem to have problems when I hit that. So I'll show you what it does. It doesn't join up here. So I just put it next to it. And that seems to work. So from here, to get a transparent background, you want to right click on the image, come down to select from path, then you want to go back to select and go invert. Then you come up to layer. You scroll down to the one that says transparency. You want to add alpha channel. Then you want to come back to layer, come back to transparency, and go color to alpha. You hit OK and press the delete button. So as you can see, that's removed the background. So that's really simple and really easy. If you want to unselect the photo, you basically just go select and none. But I'm going to leave it up for now, so I'm going to show you how to get the border. You basically go select, with obviously it's still selected from the path as you can see, and you want to go down to border. I like to use 5. I feel like that's a pretty good median. You obviously can change it to 4, 5, 6, etc. That just is the thickness of the line. So you hit OK. Now you want to make sure, so this pink square is not the one that will be the outline color. So it'll be this second one, so the white one. So you go to the bucket fill tool and you just select the border. And as you can see, it's a nice white border. If you wanted to change that, you can just go Control Z. You come to this box and you can change the color. So let's say blue. Okay. And then select. So as you can see, it'll change, but you have to make sure it's this second one here. So if we just go Control Z again, it'll get rid of that. We'll go back to, say, white. And then I'll show you now how to get a background, just a solid color background, because that's the easiest to do. So you just want to select none. Just quickly, if you don't do a white background, you may have to maneuver your sim like this, or your picture, come to the eraser tool and just erase this white line. You can leave it if you want to. I do like to get rid of it sometimes. It can get quite annoying. It's really easy to get rid of. You can change the thickness of your rubber over here. So that makes it really easy if you want to get rid of a big area. And then, yeah, so you just rub it out really good like that. Position your sim where you want them. Now, you just come up to layer, new layer, and you can either change it to the background color, so that'll make it white, as you can see the white box. If you want to make it the foreground color, that'll make it pink. So just basically go like that. It will come up on top, so you usually can just drag this layer down and it'll change. I have had this happen before. As you can see, it's obviously not dragging down. So to fix that, you go to layer, you go to stack, and you go reverse layer order. So that brings that out on top. So that's how easy that is. I will just quickly add in as well a little extra for you guys. If you want to do text, so you just hit this, obviously, the text tool, and you can start typing. So let's just do this. Obviously, it's in pink. If you start writing, you want to highlight like so. When it's highlighted, you can change the color. So as you can see, if you want to change the writing, I go by letter. So A brings up all the A's, B's will bring up all the B's. So let's go maybe this one. You can change the size. Make sure you don't unselect. Once you unselect, you can't edit it and you will have to delete the layer and redo it. So basically you just grab the move tool and you can move it to wherever you want. If you want it, obviously below, you're going to have to reverse the order layer again, so you can have writing on top of the sim if you wanted to. And if you want to delete a layer, you just right click, delete layer, and it's done. Alright, so the second way that you can do this, in terms of selecting around your sim, so I'm just going to go Control Z and get rid of everything that I've done. We'll get back to the start. So the other tool that you can use is this one here that says scissor select tool, select shapes using intelligent edge fitting. I haven't used it too much. I'm not overly a fan if you've got sort of nooks and crannies that you've got to get into, but I'll show you how to do it. It's it can be quite quicker. So say you can do longer strokes. So as you can see, it changes. Obviously, I'm just going to do it really quick. So you can be picky and go around the flowers, but obviously you see it follows the hairline really well. Now with this tool, you do want to reselect that first one. So to get it to select, from path, you can do that, or you can just hit the maneuver tool. From path doesn't work. So it's brought up what we did before, as you can see. So if we just go none, I did forget that that doesn't work. Sorry, guys. So you hit that, forget what I just said. You hit the move tool and that will select what you've just done. Yeah. So then you just go through the whole process again of inverting, transparency, add alpha channel, and color to alpha, and delete. So that's the other tool that you can use. They're the two that I use. So you've got the scissor select or the paths tool. There are probably other ways of doing this, but this is the two ways that I've found. So I hope it's been helpful. And let me know if there is another aspect of GIMP that you would like me to go through. Once you're done editing, to save, you go File. You can save as and it'll keep it so you can edit it later. I just like to go export as, export it to wherever you want. I usually just do my desktop and I keep it PNG. And then you basically just hit the export button and export again. And then that saves your image as a PNG file. So I hope that was helpful. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.